all you crafty cats and kittens. We are back with row 5. So, we are going to chain up 3, and then 2 double crochet clusters. Well, 2 double crochets to get our granny cluster going on here in our corner. And then we're going to put 3 double crochets across and then do our corner, and we're going to do that 6 times, and then we will meet back up here at the corner. I'm actually going to see how many rows we can get done in this video, and then we're going to keep doing that for our next few videos. So I will meet you back when we get to the last corner, to our other half of this corner. Pause your video. See you there. Okay, crafty cats and kittens. Well, first things first. There's a knot instead of a nice color change. It happens. But I never trust their knots. I don't like their knots. I like my knots. My knots don't come out. Oh, what type of knots do you make, you ask? Well, my knots are kind of weird. But I'll show you. Let me shift it before I paused. Alright. Take it out just a bit. Pull blue through our blue. Pull tight. Around, pull our white, through our white, pull tight. We're going to take our needle, and we're going to thread it through the center of our blue yarn. I gotta get to at least here so that when I, because I'm gonna pull the blue yarn's tail through the blue yarn. And I'm gonna do the same for the white. And I'm gonna pause you here because you don't need to watch this whole thing. We'll come back when my tails are in, okay? Now, what I have is a section that, because it's tied and then woven in, it is a little fatter than the rest of my yarn, but it's a nice strong join. And I don't have to worry about it coming undone in a washing machine. Because this is going to be a sweater. This I expect people to wear, you know, maybe outside. Maybe they'll be for a teacher who's going to wear it on a playground with, you know, a bunch of first through fifth graders. Now, so we want it to be strong. Okay. 1. We want it to be something they can throw in a washing machine. 2. And 3. And the last thing they're worried about is the seams coming out. Now, our corners, again, are half double crochets, and then we chain up 3, and now we are on row 6, so we're going to do our chain 3, 2 double crochets into the same space, get to the next space, 3 double crochets, and we are going to continue until we get to the other side of our corner again. And you're going to pause this video and you're going to join me back there, and I'm going to fix it so you aren't falling over. Sorry about that. And we'll see you when you get back to this corner. Alright, we're on our last little granny cluster. So, 3 double crochets. And double crochet into the top of your chain 3 to join. Now, chain 3 up, we're on row 7. Two more double crochets to complete your first granny cluster of your row 7. And on we go. And I will meet you back at the other half of our corner. You guys are doing great. Alright, you're back to the end of our 7th round with our last cluster in our beginning corner. Because it's our beginning corner and it's our ending corner. This time the color change was not done with a knot, it was actually a color change. So happy about that. And there we are at the end of round 7. Now, I know you all are going, "Hey, that doesn't look like a granny square." It's not. It's a granny hexagon. "Faith, that doesn't like that." You're right, because it's a granny hexagon sweater. "Faith, this doesn't look like any sweater I've ever made." You're right. It's not a raglan's type sweater. It's not a top-down sweater. It's got more seams than I actually like. But if you fold it, and I'm taking corner 1 and corner 6, which means the corner my, and I'm bringing them together, what you get is an arm and half of a front and half of a back. And you see, it's starting to look like a sweater. Now, we're at the end of round 7. And while this is only an 8-minute video, it's actually taken me 45 minutes to make this. And I'm going to tell you, it's time to hydrate. Drink some water or coffee. And we're going to meet back here in another video, because I've unfortunately have run out of recording time. Fairly in about 15 minutes, I'm going to have kids come, a teenage autistic son come in being very loud. And while I love him, he doesn't make for good videos. So, this is the end of part 3. We've done rows 5, 6, and 7. We'll meet back here next time for rows, hopefully 8, 9, and 10. In the meantime, crafty cats and kittens, have a good day. Bye.